Hello and welcome to Primecraft, guys. Welcome to Primecraft. We're having a bit of a flight here today. We're getting off to spawn. And today, wow, this feels weird. I haven't played this game now for well over a week, actually. I have been, as you may know, away in Sweden for a little school trip. Well, an educational trip for my son, as I would like to call it. So, I thought we were going to open up the Mender again here today. First thing we do. So I'm looking into what the status is of the Mender. I really like this building still. It's really cool, actually. So that's one thing we're going to do today, fiddle with that. And the next thing we're going to do is, I think, Mr. Trend has come home from his, well, you might call it his business trip. His very long business trip. And so I'm hoping to meet up with him and say hello. And maybe show him around the base and some stuff like that. And that might be, I thought, a good opportunity for you guys, if you're new, to know what's going on with the base. Aha! I found Mr. Trend, finally. He's back from his unimportant business of work. So, yeah. Hey, man, how you doing?
I'm good. Glad to be back. Happy to be back playing.
All right. So, we're going to have a look at... we're going to do a Vidagavia world tour here on Primecraft, basically, if I understand it correctly. And, yeah, so we are starting, I guess.
Oh, yeah, let's do this.
The very first thing I built here, actually.
So fast.
That's the reason we have a beacon, man. Yeah, so this is the exchange.
So this is my favorite thing.
Yeah, well, the first time I logged on here, I built this pretty much. So you can check this out in my very first episode, I think.
Yep.
Of Primecraft. And basically it's... I already at this time had the idea of making like a Viking village, and so this is kind of the first attempt at that sort of style. And I think it turned out fairly alright.
Oh yeah, I like it. I put stuff in there all the time.
Yeah, I tend to take things out. There's always this odd piece of glowstone or whatever that I feel that I need. And this here is our Podsol shop on the server. And basically, it's also one of my earlier builds. I had the idea that I wanted to, you know, make it a bit greener around spawn, and so it became a tree. So it's the first of a couple of custom trees that I've made over here in spawn.
Oh, yeah. This right here is definitely my favorite, though. Between all the ones you've built, I definitely like this one the most.
Do you really? Yeah. My favorite one is the Tree of Wisdom, to be sure. Yeah, and this one is...
Which one is that one? The one on the hill?
No, it's the one in the middle of... Well, that I'm
okay,
looking at
now. Okay.
Yeah, now this type of tree is really easy to build, actually. And in fact, I have a tutorial about it as well, so you can go and check that out if you want to learn how to build these kinds of trees.
Look down in the description for a link.
Ah, oh, there you go.
I got you.
So that's, I think that's...
I like this one. I like the size of it, but I think I just like the other tree just because of the simplicity of it. But this tree right here is still pretty awesome. I just like the other tree more.
Yeah.
This one is pretty cool.
Yeah, well, what I really like about this one is the downstairs part where you can go into it.
Oh, yeah, I forgot you did that.
And go down. And down here, you can... sacrifice your eye to the Well of Wisdom. Or if you are a coward, you can sacrifice any old spider's eye. And a book of philosophy will pop out from the gods, basically.
Oh, does it actually pop something out?
Yeah. So you're gonna have to try that later on.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Oops. I just threw a torch in there just playing. I thought you were just saying throw something in the water. Oh, man.
No, you have to do a spider's eye, actually. As a little,
okay.
Little item sorter sorting that out. I think you can have a look at that if you want to behind here.
That's pretty freaking cool. I didn't know that you did that.
So there's just an item sorter here. I think it's actually set for redstone at the moment, so I'm gonna have to fix that before you try it. But then,
Okay.
yeah, that's it. This is just a signal to the dropper that dispenses a book. Now I've only written one, but so far I think, or two possibly.
Oh,
But
I'm definitely gonna take that first.
the idea is to for me to keep writing these things, and so sort of add to it as we go along.
That is pretty freaking cool.
So there we go. Yep, here we are outside the Mender. Yeah, this is my attempt at making a steampunk build, you might say.
I really like this.
The llamas are
Compared
making
to
noises.
the shotgun you had before, definitely a huge improvement on this. I like the shotgun you had before because it was that little flat design like all the rest of the buildings, but this is definitely pretty cool. It's got the Vitagarvia touch to it, so you can definitely
Yeah.
tell it's one of the new builds.
Yeah, you know what I like best about this building, right? Is the way the stone sort of encompasses the pillars, although I'm suddenly
Yep.
noticing that this is the wrong way around, so I need to change that for various OCD reasons. There we go. So yeah, this is where we sell our mending books, although we are hard pressed to do so at the moment because we have no villagers.
Yes, because I messed that up, so I do apologize about killing the villagers.
Now we'll sort it out, don't worry about it. On the path leading to my base. This is at the moment this is like the main path past my little impromptu tree farm
Yeah,
to
I
the
saw that.
border.
That
So
cow
it's
has been in that one spot for like a good couple of days now. He
Yeah, he
just
likes
hangs
it
out.
there. Yeah, he likes it
He
there. Yeah, so this is my wall.
loves.
Enter at your own risk, basically. The idea of this path really is to walk slowly and behold the nature around you with the rocks and the bushes and
Yeah,
the whatnots.
you did a really good job here, man.
I really like it actually. It's really cool actually. It gives this very built up feel, if that makes sense. Or yeah.
Yeah, yep, absolutely. It's not just plain grass with just some buildings around. Like, you actually went around and decorated all the exterior stuff. It makes it feel
Yeah, and
more
actually,
man-made.
some of these trees are also custom made. So, like these two here
Yep.
are custom, even though they blend in rather well with the others as well.
Yep.
But so yeah, so this is my watchtower over here, and what we can also do from this is we can launch our little elytra. So I usually, when I go to spawn, I usually just jump off here and use my bow to fly over to spawn.
I still have not figured out how to use the bow, and I've done it a couple of times, but I can never stay in the air.
You have to practice. You have to
Oh,
practice.
yeah.
So yeah, over on the other side is the stables, and yeah, it's kind of the same style. I wanted something to sort of make a yard, so
Yeah.
that's why it became an L shape. And yeah,
I
that's
like it because I
that.
remember before it used to be smaller and it used to be like right over here or something. Then you
Yep,
moved it
yep.
back there and it looks a lot better like that.
Pardon me. Yeah, it's actually that's what I found on PrimeCraft. I tend to build something and then I have to rebuild it because I sort of don't plan my builds that carefully here. I just sort of build.
Yeah.
And
Yep.
so this is an example of something I've rebuilt. There's some other examples as well. Now
Oh
this
yeah, you see. Go
yeah.
ahead, go ahead.
This here
Oh, cares.
is the little storage room that I have so
Okay.
far. I am gonna build a bigger storage room. I mean, in fact, I'm in the process of doing so right now. But this is fairly typical of these buildings, right? They have the beams in the
Yeah.
ceiling, and
Yep.
they have an attic where you can have some stuff if you want to. And they're like a mix of a pine or what's it called, spruce, and this sort of cobble mix for walls. So yeah, that's how I build them.
Let's see what is. I've got nothing in there.
Actually, I owe you some diamonds, but when we're done with this, at the end of this, I'm gonna give you a gift that I have for you.
Okay. Awesome. I like gifts.
There you go. Now, if you come around here, I actually have a little secret over here.
Okay, I see.
It's nothing.
Oh, look.
It's nothing much, but this is where I have my little netherwort farm for now, down here. But I have a little spawner here as well, and this is right underneath the yard, actually. If you look up, there's a wooden plank there, and that is yep. So I'm gonna do something quite interesting with this. I've already started here. There's a tunnel here leading to the rest of my base, and I'm gonna have some fun with the zombies later on in the series. Is the idea
cool?
This is where I live at the moment. This house. It's just the tiniest little place, really. And actually, I have a tutorial on how to make that as well. So check that out.
I had to build one of those at my new base.
Yes, I'm gonna build it's a good, it's a good starter home. It is, because it doesn't look rubbish and it's still, you know, serviceable.
Yep. Oh yeah. Easy supplies.
Yep. Yep. So I had this idea. I wanted to make a Viking ship to further point out that this is a Viking base, Viking themed base. So that's what I did. I needed a bridge from here over to my mine, and the ship.
I like this. I used the trap doors like that. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. That was actually when the trap doors became like that in 1.9. I started using them. I'm using them more and more now, actually.
I think that's why you use them as ladder shoot.
Yeah. It's great for that. And I think they're actually gonna start or implement different varieties of them as well. I have a hunch. And that'll be even greater, actually. So yeah, going through here, you come to my fishing village, fishing hut even. That is now probably broken, actually.
Yeah, this one don't work anymore. At least last I had to redo mine, because I remember I had the same one. I had to redo it to the new model, and it works fine. I mean, I haven't tried it in 2 months, but
I'm sure it'll be all right. I don't fish that much anymore. It's sort of more of a starter occupation, really. So yeah, if we end a pearl in this general direction, we'll surely come to something interesting. Well, I'm underneath a tree. What about you?
Oh, I just got attacked by Endermite.
Oh, excellent. Yeah. Well, this here is... this is actually something that wasn't here last time you were on the server, I think.
Yeah.
This is...
yeah, I haven't seen this.
My encasing of my melon and pumpkin farm.
Oh, okay.
Also, I've expanded it to twice the size, so... That's cool. Once we do get a mending villager again, we'll be rolling in mending books.
Nice. I need to work on that one I have built already, but I really just don't feel like redoing the whole thing.
Did you open the door and I enderpearled and you closed the door behind me? That's funny.
Yeah.
Anyway, this path here leads to the Temple of Odin. Well, the Viking temple, anyway.
Man, I have not seen any of this. This looks nice.
And this is a cool building. It's meant to look like an Iron Age Viking house, basically. And it's basically, I needed a place to do some enchanting, and so I built this.
Oh man, like it.
Do you recognize by any chance these statues?
Yep, I do. I actually remember you building this. I just never actually came over and looked at it or nothing.
Yeah, this
is the same ones I have on my door.
Yeah, this is your design, mate. So that's cool. Thank you for that.
No problem.
It's cool. Yeah, so this window here is overlooking a lake that I found. And my idea is to spread my base basically all around this lake.
Yeah.
You can see
where's the bridge go to?
Yeah. I built two bridges. I started out by doing a bunch of infrastructures, but this is the what I'm working on now, really. This is the Viking King's house, if you will, or something like that. And this is going to be my new base, basically.
Okay.
And it's kind of inspired by the Rohirrim in Middle-earth. At least the front is, but yeah, the idea is to take the Viking theme and make something bigger with it, basically. And I have struggled a bit, but I think I'm getting there.
This is really, really good build, man. I keep saying it, but all the builds you've got so far are pretty, pretty good. I like how you incorporate so much. Like a lot of us, like especially like me, like I have the house and I've just done a whole bunch of farmings and or automatic farms and such. But you've not only done a house, but you've done like an entire like village area. It's pretty cool.
I like to spread out the functions. I don't like having sort of an enchanting station and an alchemy and a storage and a smeltery and all that all in one go. I like to spread it out because, yeah, I don't know. It makes it nicer and it sort of makes it feel like there's a point to keep building, if that makes sense.
Yeah, absolutely. I absolutely get it.
Yeah, so what I'm working on right this second before you logged on was these pillars here, actually.
Okay.
So I think I'm sort of there with them. They look really weird though, which I like.
Oh, I think they look good.
Yeah, so I guess let's go through the Nether.
Two rabbits, I would have moved them closer, but. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I asked Romy for help. I hate moving rabbits.
What are you doing rabbits
for? For my rabbit stew shop that I'm gonna make.
Can you breed rabbits?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I did not know that. Has that always been part of Minecraft?
Well, when they were first introduced, they worked kind of like cats, so they follow you around.
Never knew that. I always thought you just killed them for lucky rabbit's feet.
No, well, you can definitely breed them, and you can make rabbits stew with their meat, and yeah.
This is
my Nether tunnel. it's fairly elaborate actually, and I think it's really cool, but it's so resource intensive to build.
absolutely. I told you already that I really like this tunnel.
Yeah.
But I can definitely see what you're talking about because there's so much obsidian in here. The coal blocks. I mean, I have plenty of coal blocks if you need some. But obsidian, I don't have nowhere near enough obsidian to be able to finish this tunnel.
Actually, the two blocks, yeah, obsidian was a problem, but then I went to the end and just decimated a pillar.
Okay, I didn't think about
so
that.
So I got that covered, I think. What gives me problems is the red netherrack and the black wool, actually. Because we have no sheep farm, really, on the server. Which is kind of a problem.
Yeah, Lego needs to get on that. I know he said he has a sheep farm. He just hasn't brought it over for us to be able to buy some off of him yet.
Yeah, maybe I should build one. We'll see about that. Yeah. So anyway, this is how far I've gotten with this. So this part is kind of rough now. You have to jump around to get there.
Jump around. Jump. See, I was figuring that you were going to be coming over here and making this your new base. I thought that's what this was.
That was my idea as well, but then I got so many ideas for the Viking base that I sort of just kept going there. So yeah, this is where we're gonna have my second base in theory, but we'll see what happens with it now. For now, there's a villager breeder, and there's a couple of villagers I've stowed away in these little cells over in this cave here. I do have.
I like how you did this.
Yeah, it's all right. There are tons of. I have so many plans for this base as well, but they have to be quite far out into the future, to be honest, because I have sort of gotten dug in now with the Viking theme, and also I have games I want to make, I have spawn things I want to make, and I mean I want to, yeah. There are so many other things that I think take priority.
So, and I like how you stuck with the. Not only the Viking thing, but how you stuck with building, because you're close to spawn, but you're not that close. You're close enough to where you can just run right from spawn. You don't got to worry about running through some long tunnels to get to your base or nothing. So I like where you built that. It's pretty good.
Yep. So here we go. This is the arena. You can see it in before your eyes now. The very eyes. The sign says it all. It's the arena.
It's so cool looking, man. You should just leave it like
yeah,
this.
Yeah, I love the build.
Such a good job.
Yeah, I know. No, this is a future product, but we have been out here testing it out. So basically, there are four teams in this game. Each team has an oak pillar and a chest, and each team has a theme as well. So Basically, there are orcs, elves, dwarves, and humans, and that's
Okay.
just a way to illustrate that they have sort of different starting gear.
Okay, that makes sense.
And yeah, the idea is to make a big Colosseum-style arena here, and have sort of like a map inside it, so a strategic map with choke points and natural places for the teams to meet, and then have some treasures at each of those, so that when
Okay.
if you manage to beat the team there, you can get some better gear, and then the final show off will be in the middle, basically. That's my idea of it.
Sounds good. I think that's all right. I know you'll make something great out of it.
Yeah, I think this is a typical build for collabs, by the way. It'll be excellent for us
Oh, yeah,
to
absolutely.
all of us just dig in and build sections of the wall or whatever. So, and then obviously we can try it out as well. In fact, we can try it out now if you want.
Hey, whoa. Hey, oh, you on fire? Watch this, I'm gonna get away. No, you can't catch me. Watch this, watch this.
Hey,
Oh!
you're cheating.
No, I'm gonna die. Oh, I only got 9 levels
I'm
anyways,
stuck in your
so
eyes. That's clearly a
not
bug. Mojang, fix it. Fix your game, Mojang.
I got the high ground.
Oh,
Oh
no! Okay, man. Thank you for allowing me to ramble about my stuff for quite a while. And here's a gift that I got together for you. Just because I know you weren't here when we upgraded. So I bought you a bunch of chests.
sweet.
In fact, I have
Thank
more
you.
here. Do you have inventory space, mate? There's some more here.
Oh yeah, I got full inventory open. Now, what I'm worried about is that when I pick this up, I just use a pickaxe, right? Because I had one that Lego gave me, and I put stuff in it, and then I broke it, and then the shulker box disappeared, and then he said he found it later, but it had none of the stuff I put in it. See, maybe it just lagged out or something on me.
It probably did. I haven't had any problems with them so far.
Okay.
So
Yeah, because
then,
I had one with a bunch of stuff in it, and it disappeared on me. I was pretty upset.
yeah, I can understand that. Yeah. So I have one final thing, actually. I'm holding it in my hands right now. What do you think
What's
this
that?
is?
It's a map. Oh, hold on. Is that a cartographer map?
Yeah.
Oh, snap.
That's
How do you find these
actually
things?
from Lego and me. Because, well, you buy them from the cartographer villager, which is a new type of
Yep.
librarian villager that you buy them from. So there you go. We thought we were all going to go and do that Woodland Mansion together later on, because nobody on the server has done one yet. So
Yeah,
that's a thing.
absolutely. I'll definitely wait until we get a couple guys on and stuff. We'll have to set a date and I'll go do this together.
Yeah, sounds good to me. All right, so I think that's the tour of what I've done so far on the server. So thank you very much,
Well,
guys, for joining us on this.
yep, and thank you very much for taking me around and showing me all the awesome builds and stuff you did. And I cannot wait to see more of your stuff in the future, man.
The same to you, mate.
All
See you
right, catch you in a
later.
little bit.
Bye-bye.